gaze tugihagaze mwene ndafite pastor Alex turamwiyegereje nawe imana imuhe umugisha cyane sorry sinari nawe nzakubonye ngaho twese dufatikanye hamwe dukutire imana amashimenshi
may God bless you.
Before I finish with the message, he will come back again and sing the same song. From the minutes that I've been given, I will share with you 5 minutes. I have a piece of paper where I was sitting. I will need you to write for me your phone number. If I ever have a reason to go to men, it will be for Willie. I met him in Iowa and he was a blessing to me. May God bless you so much. I love the way he sings. He's blessed.
He's been singing since 5
years. He's
not lost his voice yet. God is so good. Proverbs chapter 8 verse 17.
Proverbs chapter 8 verse 17. We'll ask Brother Ntwari to read the chapter.
Igice cya 8 igitabo cy'imigani umurongo wa 12.
Proverbs chapter 8 verse 17. Meet
again is a blessing from God.
Nishimye cyane gusura kubona aba bakozi b'Imana.
I'm very happy to see the servants of God that are here.
Ndashima kuba Pastor Eliazar Mudakikwa.
I am thankful for the presence of Pastor Eliazar Mudakikwa.
Mu myaka ibiri ishize yari yantumiye iwabo wa Amarillo.
2 years ago he invited me to go to Amarillo.
Turanezerwa Yesu atugirira neza.
We were blessed by God.
Nashimye kubona muzehe hano nabo kwa kumwe bose
n'abamanwa. And other people, I am happy to see everybody's face here.
Samuel,
come and give me a hug, please. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Samuel is my friend. I told him that I would need to go to Labo.
Nabat.
To visit. I will go to see him. I have seen the family of
Muse.
I am very happy to see you. I am really, really happy.
Yes, I'm very happy.
May God bless you all. Those that have been with us since Saturday, and myself that is interpreting, it is good to have them like this. It's a blessing.
You don't know what you're saying. You don't know what you're saying.
Amen.
Amen.
Proverbs chapter 8, where the Bible says that I love those who love me. Those who search for me will surely find me. The Kirundi Bible is so good. It has a
good word.
It says those who search for me without ceasing will surely find me. And breath. Not taking a breath, looking for something to the point where you cannot take a breath. That person is not breathing. He is searching. That person will find me, God says. Sometimes God hides himself. And you go around find for God, you cannot find him. Looking for God, you don't find him. During the times of Job, he said, I looked for God to the right, I didn't find him. When I went to the left, I didn't find him either. When I went to the back, I didn't see him. He went to the front and he asked, where are you found? God sometimes goes away, far away from us. Jesus at the cross, he said, God, my Father, why have you abandoned me? It is God's nature. Sometimes the singer says sometimes he pretends like he's not present with us. But he is searched. And when you search him, you find him. That's the good thing. Last time, there is some things that we did talk about, but we're not going to repeat them. But I just want to give you a summary of it. Those who read the English Bible, when you read from the King James Version,
I love them.
It says, I ndabakunda.
Those who love me.
Abo bankunda nanje ndabakunda. That means the person
has to have the love of God first. Has to love God first.
This is the first.
And then God pays back the love. You need to separate, get the difference. Do not say that God doesn't love everybody. And think that He doesn't love those who don't love Him.
Oh yeah?
No.
Imani kunda bantu bose.
God loves all of us.
Kandi idukunda kimwe.
And He loves us all equally.
Ikintu kidafindangaza.
What astonishes me?
Uko nta kintu noba ngikoze.
There is nothing else that I can do.
Nawe ntacho wabugikoze.
There is nothing else that you can do.
Kugira ngo Imani igukunde kurushaho.
For God to love you more than He has ever loved you.
Yarangije kugukundishira wakadomo.
He has loved you maximally.
Irarangiza.
He has finished with His love.
Wakwikeba n'ibyuma.
Even if you cut yourself.
Wava maraso.
When you start bleeding.
Diyo subira kurenzaho yakubwiye.
God loves you ever more than He has loved you.
No kuvuga ngo yageze kukanda.
That means He has come to the last point.
Watangibyawe.
If you give all
what
you have, even if you don't give anything,
ukundeba.
The way you see me here, He has loved me. There is nothing else that I can do. There is nothing else that I can kneel more than what I do. I cannot scroll down for God to love me more. He has finished with His love that and He closed all the love.
Amen.
Let me tell you this.
You are
the one that has a debt. You have.
And
God has done His part of loving you. You are still in need of love to God. Because God has already loved you. My brothers. Let me tell you what I have realized. God loves everybody. Matthew chapter 5 verse 4. Please, my brother, read the verse. Matthew chapter 5 verse
44. I can't
wait. Matthew chapter 5 verse 44 and 45.
Yego. Ichaga
Banuka
Kuko Ategeka Isu Wagi,
eh?
Kurasia Ababinaveza.
For He commands the sunlight
Kuvira Ababinaveza
to both the evil and the good.
No shakan to Rakari Shamburakari.
Even if you are happy or not about it,
Murubi Guawe.
It's going to fall to them. The ones you love and the ones you do not love. And you cannot do anything about it. Because in this book of the Proverbs,
Solomon yazayerekana nature.
It says that Solomon was illustrating the nature of God. And the nature of God is love. And those who love, they love all. And they should love the evil. Starting from me.
But wait,
maybe you was good. You had good conduct. But as I know myself and my heart, and how I went around and hiding God, you should know yourself. He loved me.
I was not deserve. I didn't deserve it. He says, I love people that love me. But the Bible doesn't say that he doesn't love those who don't love him.
Oh yeah.
No.
Mose hari ya mudice cha mirongo chagata mirongo ine nagata tu uzamute.
Moses chapter 5 verse 43.
Mugutegeka yari yarabwiwe n'Imana muri amategeko.
Commandments God had told him this.
Ngo ukunde ugukunda wangu mwanzi wako.
Love those who love you and hate those who do not love you.
No, 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 buku yikinyo na umkuririnde.
If anybody takes a tooth from you, you should also detooth them.
No, 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 kumenyijisho na umumenirinde.
If a person does something bad to your eye, you should do the same way to them.
Yakuraga mwiryo ndakubwira ko itegeko ryake ndaryari rimeze.
Let me tell you what the commandment says.
Nimba bagukuye mwiryo buryo.
If someone took a right eye from you,
nawe niryo bamukuraga.
The same right eye should be taken from you.
Nimba yakuye iryinyo ry'imbere.
If that person takes a teeth.
Nimba ikofi yaguteyaga kuri ikijigo, nawe nico bakuraga.
You should punch them back.
Yes, ngwaze asanga niko abayuda
babigize. When Jesus came, people fearing each other.
Atada kumubwirira wamutera igisebo uruguma. Uruguma rwahorerwa urundi ruguma.
An excuse to them.
Bakapimarya wamukomerekeje.
They should measure or do a survey.
Bakamenya mezire nuko igisebe kingana.
To know how the
nuko cinjiye cagiye kure. Ha ha ni ha ni ha ha ni ha.
The same spot.
Umugabo umwe w'umunyabwenge.
A wise man
yaravuze ngo nimba ijisho ryokurwa mu kubera irindi ngo twokwisanga twese si yose arimo.
Said that if an eye would be removed because another eye was removed, everybody would be blind. If I do something wrong,
kandi ngira umunsi mba ndengeje amakosa abiri.
I do more than two mistakes a day and I have only two eyes. How
many
eyes would be taken from me?
Nawe wagirindi bagukuramo
blind. Everybody around the world would
yes, be blind.
Jesus looked around and he said, all you people will be blind. All you people will have gaps in your mouth. All you people will have gaps around your teeth. And he said, I tell you this. Love those who love you and those who do not love you.
No,
the good and the evil. Another extra thing that you should do that I think is difficult. I am short, but I'm kind of stubborn. For another man to come and punch you, and you turn around and you allow them to hit you again. Letting them punch me again. I will tell them your mom had you for 9 months.
The
same 9 months I was in my mother's womb. You have two arms, I have two arms as well. You know the next. When someone starts telling you that, let me tell you this. Goodness, when someone punches you on the right side, you should turn around and let them punch you to the left side. God loves the evil.
Well.
We like praying and thanking the people
that
gave you pray for those that gave you something.
Mumusengere n'abahuzi banyu ngo kandi mubaheze n'umugisha ngo nimba muza amazi yo kunywa ubwire gute nanabura n'icyo kurya umubwire gute abayuda bati iyi vanjiri
irakomeye This is not what we heard from Moses.
Before.
If a person takes an eye from you, punch or kick to another with another kick.
No,
so how can we pray for those people? Not at least running away or walking away.
Dio.
Ima.
God
is
the father to all of us.
Hallelujah!
God is the father of all of us. God is the father to the orphans. God is the father to the widows. God is the father to the rich people and the poor people. The strong people and those that are blessed or humble. He is the father to all nations. Don't be jealous because Father God is the father of your friend. Let me tell you this. I know people who are easygoing. We need to be easy, we need to be humble. Even those whom you don't love, they will go to heaven with you if you get a chance to go to heaven. What will you do if they come to heaven with you? What will you do? Humble yourself because it is good to humble yourself.
If
the heaven is not
the heaven is not
your heavens. You are not the usher to the heaven's gate.
Hallelujah.
Love all. Be easy, be welcoming. Be welcoming to everybody. There is a prayer that is difficult for me to pray sometimes.
Yes, we are saying
Jesus prayed, Jesus and his disciples prayed this prayer. And Nehemiah said the same prayer, and Daniel did the same
thing.
People would not confess or repent their sins. Pastors, should we always pray for this?
Amen.
Whom God has given us.
Hallelujah!
Because this prayer, the Bible accepts
it.
Even Jesus has prayed this prayer. And after Jesus, I haven't seen anybody else that prays as better as praying. Even Jesus said, God, may you please forgive them because they don't know what they are doing. They don't know what they are doing. Let me ask you, would Jesus have prayed this prayer if he knew that God was not going to forgive
him?
No. If you hear Jesus repeating the same prayer, Stephen, when he was being stoned, he prayed the same prayer for the people. Do not judge other people because you don't know when they repent. You don't know when they are forgiven.
Amen.
Do you know when he came crying to God? Do you know anybody else that went to God for their sake? If you pray for me, God will bless me.
Hallelujah.
When you find time for God, you find a little time for God.
utinone za company.
So somebody might ask themselves, how about the work?
The company says it.
The companies are not.
When we finish the room, we will watch this.
Now the people have
had a long time. What was the
tuzazisigaho turazikunda ziduheza amadorari
tukagendera n'umuntu tukatwendera
neza
none se imana yo ntakanyu yiheza umwana wa da
icya
kabiri twavuze
secondly that we say
ni mvugo communication
kuko your attitude your communication
ukunda imana
do you love him
mugari awiru yibwi
when you come in front of him talk to him express yourself
urishimye
are you happy
yibwire ko wishimye
tell him about your
urababaye
are you sorrowful
yibwire ko ubabaye uyibwire ni pamvu ubabaye
why are you
vuka vuka yumve
talk to God
impamvu giye kuvuga hano
the reason why I'm about to repeat this
mukumenyana
is knowing each other
kumenyana
knowing each other
iyo mumaze kumenyana
when we know each other
murushaho gukundana
we love each other more
tuzukunda neza umuntu utaramenye
you can't love a person that you have not known
yes kumenyana n'Imana
knowing God
nico chatumye nabwiye uri ndi wiri mwana wa data
that's why I told my brother we need
bankundirimbira ngo ura nduwiwe nache nu nduwiwe nawe nuwanje
says I am his
ngo kumumenya ni bobusi
and knowing that is life to me yebo yebo
iyo wamenyanye ni imana
when you have known God and God knows you
murakundana
you both love each other
abantu bagishaka
people that are really well
bazabagira sorry le nouveau marié il ben chingo shasha sorry ngo shasha
the new marriages
baba batarakundana neza
they have not come to that kind of deep love
mureke kumbeje twatundi mwanditse kwa kuri WhatsApp no kuri twa Facebook mukara ba fiance mwae
mumu don't worry about the messages the text messages that you text with
oheza kugashya nta uzinziriye oheza
message texting each other
Tiwarangije kutwandika.
Tumwavuganye.
Tumwapanze na gahunda y'umunsi w'ubukwe. Ubukwe tibwabaye.
And the wedding is
happening. Cumwe rutikirange mwarangije
no first week after the wedding.
Ushobora kutaza wosura kubona kandi ka message kiwe.
Never receive another message from them again.
No gaza mwandikira nyine. Kuko ndi twaje kumwe. Ubari hano.
I left them because I wasn't with them, but now we are
going to text them.
Is there any reason else for them to text them? How am I going to text you when I see you, when you're like, I'm with you?
Umukobwa gategereza twatu message twahani twabiki twagenze
twabagutse. Wait and wait for the messages, never. Nowhere to be found.
Umuhungu ati ka twatunzwe akazinyandikira umwana wa data.
The guy says the messages, the sweet messages that he used to send me. How about that?
Kwari amaresha mugeni se abasaza barayaze. Bagira ngo tutere umwe twita amaresha mugeni.
We used to have words that would entice.
Taha dututaba.
They are everywhere.
Kwari utumezaje twa amaresha mugeni.
Those messages was just to entice you or to lure their hearts.
Nimumara kugera mu nzu.
When you come to the house.
Nambi mwahuye.
After you both met.
Niwe muri butangire kumenyana.
It's when you will start knowing each other.
Ndiwe umenyana n'Imana mutarahuka
nayo. No God after
you. Iyo mumaze kwegerana nayo.
Once you meet God and you are close to him.
Muratangira kumenyana.
Then you know him.
Hallelujah. Hari bintu bine by'ingenzi.
There are four things that are important.
Bizatuma abantu bamenya.
That makes people know each other.
Umugore wawe.
Your wife.
N'umugabo wawe.
And your husband.
Azakumenya neza muri abakene.
Know each other during the poverty.
Umukene.
When you are poor.
Uzumenye uwo mwubakanye wari we.
You know who you got married to.
Niba kiza kivuzinduru
when he's a crying boy
niba igihamu kumuntu wigikange
if he
is a person that gets scared for every situation. Whenever just the shooter is not around in the house, and the wife starts crying for something, and says, oh, I cannot remember this
person.
They say, how can we spend the whole day without having even
tea?
If this is how we're going to live, I don't understand how we're going to survive. And the man says, how can I, where do you want to find this sugar for your tea? So what are you doing here? Go find it. Go find the sugar. What are you doing in the house?
Yeah, man.
You will start knowing what is made out of. You will know. If they are Chinese, you will know. If they are fake hearts that came to you, you will get to know that. Fake people. When you are in poor, when you have a situation, you will get to know you. Who are you married with? Who are they really? When there is no flour in the house, and they ask you, are you just sitting around here? What are you doing? And will you know, even if you wake up, you're not going to do anything. And you say, let us stay in my bed. You sleeping, the way you know each other, those young ones, do you know why?
They don't have an experience.
They're not experienced yet. Have you ever seen a lady, a young lady that's still at their parents' house? Here in America, they have everything. Even if you go to shower, you have all the makeups and everything. Everything to make them up. To make themselves up. Everything. When they are still at their house. That's just something that will go away in a second.
After you are married
and you will not do anything about it. You are already married. If he ever touches me. If he ever touches me after we are married. Because some people feel that they are better than others, but put yourself in that shoes first.
Woman!
God!
Woman!
And they start saying, and you start naming everything that God has given you. And God, I'm going to go back to the
Bible.
He will never do that just because you want it to happen. There is nothing that you can do for God's goodness. There is nothing else either that you can do for Him to love you even more. The ages that we are in right now,
turi ba bagabo biteguye.
We are ready.
Tachakiwa kuri yisi utobabari mugore wa.
There is nothing that your wife can do that is unforgivable to you. Because we've spent so long together. Let me tell you this. Something else that will make you. I told you that poverty will make you know something. It will make you know your husband who really is. You will know that he's a strong man. He comes up in the morning and tells me, my wife, you know, there is no money today. There is nothing to eat. We still love each other. When we find something, we'll thank God. And we can find anything to eat. Still, we still love each other. Let me ask. You know, food in America is there all the time. Have you ever
everybody.
Tomorrow God will provide.
Amen.
That's how we spend time with Him.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Riches will make you know the real person that you live with. All these women that are here, before they got rich, you didn't know them very well. Now you know them. She can go to the market and brings you a very nice expensive shoes. You didn't even tell
her.
No, the color that you
surprising
that it comes with a surprise to you. I wish she had the money all the time, all the times. And all this time, she always had this good kind of heart. She had a real. Or your son tells you, hey, Dad, I'm graduating very soon. And you start laughing and you're happy about it. That's how God does to us. Even my wife did not know me very well. Because
there
were things that I wanted to do to her, but I didn't have a way to do it. But now that I'm able to do it, that's when she will know who I really am. And early in the morning, your wife comes to you and tells you, you know, we need to go outside. And she tells you, I'm the one that's going to take over the car. And she puts you in the car. And she rides with you. And she takes you to a very nice store and tells you, you know what, choose. Make your own choice from all those suits. Because she didn't have the money, but she had the mind of doing it. Now you're getting to know her.
This is the time.
There are some things that people don't realize. In the family, engaging to each other is something that you have to work for.
Hallelujah!
It is something that you have to find.
baza tugira ibibazo bimwe bimwe.
Men in the families will have different problems.
Uke muri byo muwawe.
You have to solve your family's problems. And you also have to care for the problems on the other side.
Niko kalicha zacu.
That's how our culture is.
Kandi muri kalicha zacu.
And in our cultures, it is shameful. A man like Samuel
to just be
a man in his own marriage, his wife and kids. In his clan, they do not consider him as a real man. They say that he just cares about his wife. When he's not caring for his wife, he's just caring for his children. Other than that, he is not worried about anything else. That's not how we know people. Once we've known God, we also start caring about the other people on the other side. God comes to you and tells you, why are you still sitting
here? When you look at God,
He points at you,
gives you
tells you what to do. Your neighbor is in need of something.
Amen.
Don't say.
Now, the money that you had, what did you do with it?
Madam,
when your wife asked
you,
you say that I've spent the money on this and the rest of the money has helped somebody. And the lady comes up to you. Something that helps you knowing who the person is really is, let them get mad, just a little bit. Just test them, just do something to them. Just provoke them with something. And they tell, oh, why are you despising
me?
Cats. When there is nothing that's going on, they are hiding their crows. But when a cat sees a rat,
they open up their crows.
A lion opens up their crows when they see something. A person that's still humble and calm, wait until they get mad. Sometimes when people are mad, they start shaking. When they start speaking, they start saying things and they don't know what they're saying. People start regretting when they see those kind of situations coming.
And the wife says, what are you doing? What are you doing?
When a person is mad, you get to know who they are and they can handle.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah. How can you handle and solve the situation? There is two ways you can do that. At least someone is going to come.
Everybody has
If no one comes down, the situation is not going to be solved. That's why when we
raise
up and God comes up with you, when we come down to surrender, we say, God, oh my God, this is amazing, this tool I cannot do it anymore.
Mistakes that we
have
done. You hear the word of God, the voice of God telling you that whatever you've done, God has warned you. Am I going to want him back? No.
Papa,
I will kneel down and say, God, all I can do is to ask for forgiveness. We ask for forgiveness, we have ourselves down, and the Father's name is glorified. When your wife does that, you know she is mature. You start saying, oh, I never expected her to treat me like that. I like how she handled the situation. Now we are peaceful in the marriage. Knowing each other makes each other's love grow. God loves, we love God and he loves us because we've spent long time with them, we know each other. When he tells us we hear, there are some situations that you know in your marriage that there is something wrong that's going to happen. Have you ever had problems like this? Don't you think it is a pride for your husband to take care of your family and be able to take care of other people's families? What kind of Christian are you doing? What kind of salvation do we have? It is people should go out and pray. People should go and have different children and take care of other people's needs. People can read letters in English. If your husband knows how to read English, go, you read them, you open up your mailbox every day and there's letters all the time. My wife listens to me. Let me talk to you this. I don't want you to leave work and you start going all the way around and from
Hallelujah.
We have men of God that are